Okay.
Okay, so I was just watching some videos from the Global Cycling Network YouTube channel, which I'm not sure where the global is. It seems to be mostly British people, entirely British people. I'm not sure. But that, whoa, hello. In addition to some amusing attempts at riding recumbents, it seemed like they could have used more practice, but it looked like they were having fun, which I appreciated. They did the world record attempt for pulling a caravan, a camper trailer, by bike. And I guess Guinness said they would publish it if the GCN could manage, I think it was 25 miles an hour, pulling a 700-pound camper, I want to say, which I'm not sure how feasible that is, but their first attempt was pretty much a failure. They hooked it up with a really underwhelming hitch, and it looked like the camper rolled forward, crushed the bike, took the rear wheel off. The rider was lucky to get out of the way, so they took it to a welder, and the welder built a nice hitch that connected to the quick release and the seat post and the seat stays, which is pretty good. And they got back out on their test track, and they've got this hitch set up so that the center of the rear wheel is here and the hitch is here, which no wonder the top of a 700c wheel is well above the point where you can attach a normal car trailer hitch. But that means that when the weight of the trailer, which I think they said they had, like, I don't remember if it was 35 pounds or 35 kilos pushing down, I think it was kilos pushing down on that hitch, which is pretty significant. That was enough to lift the front wheel of the bike quite a bit, so they had no traction on the front wheel and they weren't able to steer. And then they dropped the little caster wheel on the front of the trailer and that lifted the rear wheel and they didn't have traction to actually drive the bike forward. The rear wheel was just slipping. It seems like there's a couple of mechanical solutions they could have tried that would have improved this. One, the first thing I would have done is gone and gotten a Brompton. I don't know if the little 16-inch wheels on a Brompton are quite small enough to fit under a trailer hitch, but they'd be pretty close, and at the very least, then you've got maybe 8 inches of leverage between your, well, okay, 10 probably, because you've got to have some clearance for the hitch, between your hitch and your axle. Instead of a 700c wheel, you're going to have almost 20, so that cuts the lever in half. Second option would be just use a tricycle. I mean, a trike on a flat course, especially with that much weight resting in between the two rear wheels, you'd want a delta trike, not a tadpole, of course. That would be decent. Although, if the trailer starts to slew sideways, it might flip the trike. So I don't know about that one. And third possibility. Yeah, I was going to say, because they were having trouble lifting the rear wheel, you could use a front-wheel drive bike, something like a Python Low Racer, but then you're going to have the same trouble with the steering slipping, so that wouldn't work. Anyway, I think they could have done mechanically better if they go for a second attempt. I'd say first try a Brompton. And if that doesn't work, then try a delta trike. Ready? Okay, I just realized the third thing that would probably be even simpler in a lot of ways is to build a custom trailer hitch. Take something that's a little more like the hitch that they use on, I think, Surly's Bill and Ted trailers. Where I believe this is how they work. They have the two different axes of rotation. Well, you really need three axes. Yeah, you need three axes of rotation, but you have them operating at different points. So one axis is the, I think in airplanes, this would be called pitch, maybe? If that's the front of the bike out that way. The movement of the trailer hitch this way to accommodate irregularities in the road. You know, your rear wheel goes over a bump, but the trailer hasn't hit it yet, and it goes ka-thunk, and then the trailer hits it, and it has to do that. So you have that right at the axle, where all of the weight of the trailer is going to be bearing down on your axle, right on the contact point where the wheel hits the road. I don't know if these hand gestures mean anything, but hopefully they're conveying something. But then the trailer's ability to turn as your bike turns, that's located behind the wheel. You really can't do that at the axle unless you're putting it over the wheel, like I was talking about with Brompton. So you move the turning back here, and then somewhere, probably also back here, you have some roll so that if the road isn't even, if it's doing this, or if you have to lean your bike over into a turn but the trailer can't lean over, then the two pieces aren't in conflict that way. The bike can lean over and the trailer can stay upright. So that might be the easiest, is to just build a custom trailer hitch. But I don't know. Actually, a Brompton would be easier if it would work. But if they're really set on using the road bike, and they do like their road bikes on GCN, it seems like that'd be the way to go.